You are listening to the audio production of Understanding the Purpose and Power of Men, God's Design for Male Identity by Dr. Myles Munroe, published by Whitaker House. This book is read by BZ Cullins. Dedication. To my beloved son, Cairo, with a hope that the content and principles of this book will become the quality of your character and the story of your life. To Paul, forever my brother in this life and the next, may your memory live on through the things you taught me as a real male man. To my beloved dad, Matt Munroe, my male mentor. To the men of BFM Fellowship's Real Men Ministry, your passion for truth inspires. To males of every race, culture, creed, and nation in your struggle to discover and master the mystery of being a man. To the third world man in his pursuit to recover his lost identity. To the manufacturer of the man and the male. Preface. The 21st century male is in crisis. Throughout the nations of our global village, the prisons are filled with multitudes of men. Compared to their counterpart, women, they're responsible for a vast majority of criminal behavior worldwide. They are also victims of drug abuse and the principal carriers of the dreaded AIDS virus. Many have found a home in subculture gangs, instigating antisocial activities that wreak havoc on the social order. Men revel in the oppression of women and perpetuate domestic violence. In every culture and social system, men are struggling to find their place in a fast-changing world. In many societies, the dramatic change in the status of women, the workplace, and traditional cultural roles has left a significant number of men confused, disillusioned, angry, frustrated, and traumatized. Yes, the male of this cyber-technical, internet-driven, postmodern world is caught in a worldwide web of confusion. Men are in trouble, but are afraid to admit it. They are lost in a maze of new paradigms and the uncharted waters of social and cultural convergence. Change is often the source of uncertainty and a measure of fear and anxiety. For many, this type of fear is difficult to manage, and it causes varying reactions. Some negative reactions to change include denial, ignorance, isolation, anger, resistance, and resentment. These reactions can cause serious effects on the environment in which the change is taking place. The result can be oppression, suppression, violence, and the spirit of control. A brief study of the behavior of the male factor in many nations today, including yours, will reveal such reactions to cultural changes. The drastic transitions taking place in social structures and the shifting of long-held beliefs are destroying the defining lines and the very definitions of our lives. For the male in most societies and cultures, this redefinition is traumatic and has rendered many men without a clear definition of manhood, masculinity, and fatherhood. The impact of the confusion on women, the family, and society is also frightening. Many women suffer the violence of angry men. Children are victims of abuse and resentment, and society bears the scars of social deterioration. Governments are helpless to respond to this phenomenon. They find their ideas, laws, and social programs ineffective in addressing it. Men are clearly in trouble. So, what is a man to do? The number one challenge to the male is his identity crisis. The average man is confused about his manhood, masculinity, and sexuality. He doesn't have a clear definition of what a man is supposed to be. Some men have confused their cultural, social, and traditional roles with the definition of manhood. However, this has proven to be one of the major causes of the problem because as the roles change, so does a man's image of himself. How do we measure a man? What is true manhood? How do you define masculinity? What is true male sexuality? What is true purpose of the male in relationship to the female? Is there a universal definition of manhood? Can it be attained? Where do we go to get this definition? This book addresses answers to these critical questions from the perspective of the male. The purpose and role of the male in the scheme of the human experience is explored through returning to the original process of his creation based on the premise that no one knows the product like the manufacturer. No product can understand its identity by asking the customer, because only the manufacturer knows the original purpose and potential of his product. Therefore, it is imperative that the male rediscover his original purpose and understand his true potential, as well as gain a clear understanding of his principal function within the human family. The male is the key to building strong, enduring social infrastructures, stable families, sane societies, and secure nations. It is critical that the subject of the male's crisis be a priority for men, women, and national governments so that we can secure progressive social developments within the countries of the world. Let us begin our journey through the land of cultural confusion to rediscover the purpose and power of the real male. Introduction. The male holds the key to the nations, and our nations are in crisis. As the man goes, so goes the family, society, and the world. The problem is, men don't have a clear idea of where they're going anymore. They are suffering from a loss of sense of identity, and the consequences for their families, communities, and nations are far-reaching. Conflicting views of manhood. Traditional male roles once gave men continuity and balance from generation to generation. Today, many men are questioning who they are and what roles they are to play in life. On the surface, they may be following customary life pursuits, such as working, marrying, and having a family. Yet they have an inner uncertainty about what it means to be a man, a husband, and a father. What is causing this uncertainty? A major reason is that society is sending out conflicting signals about what it means to be a man. Traditional views of masculinity compete side by side with new ideas of manhood in the marketplace of ideas, each vying for supremacy. A clash of old and new ideas. This contest of ideas is being played out as we absorb the vast social and political changes that have taken place over the last 40 years. On both national and international levels, cultures and ideas are colliding. As a result, people are reevaluating what it means to be human, what it means to be a man or a woman, and what it means to be a country. Some of these developments are the movement for women's equality, the exportation of Western culture in the world, the fall of communism, the global marketplace, a growing interconnectedness between nations. Whether worldwide or locally, our world is rapidly changing before our eyes, and the social transformation accompanying it can be painful. The clash of old and new ideas has left many men perplexed and frustrated in regard to their identity. How do their new roles, for example, equal partnership with women, play out against traditional ones such as breadwinner and protector? Men are feeling compelled to redefine their roles as they attempt to adapt to these changing social expectations. This adjustment is disrupting both their professional and personal lives. It is altering their relationships with women. It is transforming family life. Yet the lines of these new roles look blurry to men as traditional and contemporary ideas eclipse, overshadowing one another, and then separate again. For example, on the one hand, men are told there is no real difference between males and females and that they are to consider women as equals. On the other hand, they are encouraged to treat women with special care and courtesy, but when they do, they are often accused of chauvinism. The male in crisis. Historically, men have defined their manhood by the various roles they have fulfilled for their families and for society. Now that the roles are in transition, they don't have a solid definition of masculinity to give them a cultural context for life. As a result, many men believe they have lost a part of themselves, but they don't have anything concrete with which to replace it. Often, they don't even feel wanted or needed by women any longer. They used to have clear direction about where they were going as men. Now, it's as if they are trapped in a maze, frustrated, and unable to move forward purposefully in life. Some men have reacted angrily against the women's movement and other social changes. They have no intention of adapting. Instead, they have reasserted or tightened their traditional dominance over women because they are afraid of losing control. They have reacted by being either competitive or isolationist. They are domineering or even abusive to their families. In certain countries, men have aggressively fought back on a national level. They have countered the advancement of women's equality with severe restrictions on the lifestyle and freedoms of women because they perceive these changes to be part of the westernization of their societies. a moral corruption that is harming their way of life. A crucial crossroads. Why is the male's crisis of purpose such a pivotal issue? For one thing, it attacks the core of who men are, leaving them indecisive and foundationally weak. For another, it reflects a breakdown in understanding, communication, and cooperation between men and women that is unnatural and unhealthy. Men are at a crucial crossroads, and where they go from here will have a serious effect on the course of society. The crisis of purpose they are experiencing will escalate if they continue to live in an uncertain or defensive state of mind. They will remain frustrated and will live at a level far below their potential. Moreover, the cracks in the foundation of society will grow dangerously wider. What should men do? Should they hold on to traditional roles and ways of thinking? Or should they follow the road being paved by new concepts of maleness? It would be difficult to stop the flow of change, and we would not want to return to tradition merely for the sake of tradition. The old system did not reflect the full purpose and potential of men, and women were often devalued under it. Yet contemporary concepts of maleness are often ambiguous. They also tend to focus on roles rather than on the male's underlying purpose and identity, a crucial distinction that this book explores. What kind of world will we have if we keep following this new path? We already have some idea of the negative effects that a continuing male crisis of purpose would bring. Many of our current social problems, such as teenage pregnancy, crime, and poverty, flow from purposelessness and rootlessness among men. The majority of crimes worldwide are committed by men. 90 to 95% of those in prison in the United States are males. Recently, I've been amazed at the increasing number of boys who are involved in crime. We are seeing more and more criminal activity by males between the ages of 9 and 18. In London, a 5-year-old boy was murdered by an 11-year-old boy. In Chicago, a 6-year-old girl was murdered by a 9-year-old boy. I remember when criminals used to be old men. How often do you see a list of crimes that were committed during a given week in which 50% of the culprits were women? Never. It's really a male issue. Whether we're talking about a broken home, an abused wife, an abandoned child, or a crime, we are looking primarily at a male problem that stems from a misguided purpose or a lack of true identity. The issue is purpose, not maleness. Why are many social ills caused by men? It may be tempting for some to dismiss males as hopelessly aggressive and domineering, with an essential nature in need of an overhaul. I'd like to present an alternative perspective. The problem is not a biological one of maleness, but a spiritual one of identity. Male identity is not essentially a matter of roles, which vary with culture and shift with changing times. It is a matter of inherent purpose. Therefore, to address the problems of our society and the world, we must start with the male and how he perceives himself. If men knew who they really are and their true reason for being, then their confusion, anger, and destructive behavior could be replaced with purposefulness, confidence, and a building up of society. It's when men don't know who they are and what purpose they have in this world that we experience a myriad of cultural problems. While society is feeling the effects of the male's dilemma, it is also apparently contributing to it by presenting incomplete or confusing ideas of manhood. In this way, society is unknowingly bringing trouble upon itself. This double-edged sword is not new to our generation or our world. The consequences of ignorance of purpose. The crisis we are seeing today is actually a contemporary version of an age-old dilemma. Men and women alike lost their concept of what it truly means to be human, male and female, a long time ago. The problem is also not confined to particular cultures. The question of identity is a global problem. I have traveled many nations, and I've concluded that most of the world is suffering from what I call the consequences of ignorance of purpose. In every nation, in every community, no matter what language the citizens speak or what color their skin is, people are experiencing a common dilemma. They are suffering the debilitating effects of misconception of purpose. They don't understand who they really are, and therefore aren't living up to their full potential in life. In my earlier book, Understanding the Purpose and Power of Woman, I showed how humanity's ignorance of purpose has historically degraded.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.